common SCC is a disease mainly treated in office practice medicine. So I mean, in situ or minimally invasive tumors can be treated by simple methods, sometimes just for ablation, but not surgical excision. We can apply some treatment procedures like cryotherapy, like curettage and electrosurgery, even sometimes with CO2 laser, but those kind of treatments are closely reserved for this type of tumors, tumors with in situ characteristics or with minimally invasion. Otherwise, we have to apply surgical methods. And for common SCC, for common invasive SCC, we are able to treat most of cases with standard surgery with fixed margins. We have observed several reports about what is a correct margin, a good margin for excised SCCs, and most of the evidence shows that for low-risk tumors, at least a 4 millimeter margin achieves a 95% of cure rate. That's good for a treatment method, so we are happy with that. For low-risk tumors, but high-risk tumors need in standard surgery at least 6 millimeters margin to achieve the same cure rate, because the invasiveness of the tumor is higher. How do we define a high-risk tumor? Well, that is a tumor with one or more features that gives a higher risk of recurrence or even a higher risk of metastasis. So, I mean tumors larger than 2 centimeters, some specific locations like the lip, the ear, or extremities, and some features in the histological point of view, namely tumors with low differentiation, tumors with perineural spread, and currently some molecular features are pointed out as the future, as methods to define properly the aggressiveness of the tumor. Some mutations, some expression of molecules like the PD-1 ligand, or some mutations like the third promoter gene mutated that gives a poorer outcome. So those kind of factors, a mixture between clinical, histological, and molecular factors, I mean that in the future, those are the factors related with the high risk definition. For finish my presentation in the World Congress of Melanoma about this subject, I talked about Mohs micrographic surgery. I think Mohs micrographic surgery is a good method for high-risk invasive cutaneous SCC. However, there are some pitfalls about Mohs surgery, because in frozen sections, SCC cells can be confounded with keratinocytes because some artifacts of the procedure. So sometimes we have to apply some immunostaining to improve the outcome, but in those cases of high-risk SCC, particularly with perineural invasion, we can observe a large advantage in using these micrographic controlled procedures.